Hello guys, welcome back with me, CiaoCiao2025. Today we're going to install Reactor Face Swaper for ComfyUI. What we need first is Git, ComfyUI and Cuda. How to install them could refer on the link on the description. In this video, I use Cuda 12.1, so we're going to face a lot of problem in this installation because this thing was supposed for Cuda 11.8. First, access the GitHub page, link on the description. Next, click the code button and the copy the script or link. Access the ComfyUI custom node directory and open command prompt from there. The directory is ComfyUI/custom_nodes. From the command prompt, write git clone and paste the link with right click. You could also copy paste it from the description. After it finished, a new folder called ComfyUI Reactor Node will be created. Access that folder. You will find install.bat there. Double-click it to execute installation process. As you can see, we finished installed Onyx 1.16. The problem is 1.16 is not for our CUDA. Also, if you have problem other than that, you could install Wheel manually by downloading Wheel for your portable Python. Check the portable version Python by opening command prompt from Comfy Portable Root Directory. Write python-embedded/python.exe-v. Finally, based on your Python version, copy one of the link in the GitHub. Download them at the ComfyUI Portable Root Directory. Update your pip using the script using python-embedded/python.exe-mpipe install-upipe. And do pip install them by copying the script on the GitHub page. After that, go back to ComfyUI/custom_nodes and rerun the install.bat. I don't think this is necessary, but I do it anyway. Now we could try to run ComfyUI. It will download and set up a bunch of things. If your ComfyUI start up without node, don't worry. It's simply just downloading file and the system not fully set up yet. A few minutes will pass and finally nodes will be showing up. Clear all the nodes. Add nodes from Reactor Fast Face Swap. Add two load image node. Also add preview image for the result. Connect the image to input image and source image. Connect the Reactor image result with preview image. Input image is the image that the face is going to be changed. Source image is the face that will be put on the input image. Refer face restore model to my upscaling video, link on the description. Basically, it just to decide how will the face will be fixed. The more the visibility and strength, the better the face will be, but it will also reduce the similarity of the source image face. Run it by clicking Q prompt. It will first start downloading model. In my case, since we used the wrong CUDA, we will met this error. CUDA path is set, but CUDA wasn't able to be loaded. Please install the correct version of CUDA and CUDNN, as mentioned in the GPU requirements page. A link in bracket. Make sure they're in the path and that your GPU is supported. I'm not sure which step able to solve this, but hear what I do. First, I install CUDNN from NVIDIA site, link on the description. Refer to support matrix between CUDA and CUDNN version. In this case, since I use CUDA 12x, I download CUDNN version 9. Download the CUDNN library and install it. If you are asked to restart your computer first, do so. After that, just install it like regular installation process. Now access your CUDNN installation directory. Before you do this, I suggest you make a backup of your CUDA toolkit first. Copy all the folder in the bin, include and lib directory for 12.3 to your CUDA toolkit folder. Paste it in the same bin to bin, include to include and lib to lib. The next step is to uninstall Onyx Runtime and force it to install onnxruntime-gpu for CUDA 12. Copy the script from the video description. After some long loading, now let's try again. Quew! Prompt, and here are the results. Here, another example. Anyway, guys, that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. See you again on the next episode. And have a nice day. Please subscribe.